Okay, let's keep waxing philosophical with Cortez here.
Yeah.
Good. And I'll do my best to explain everything. Just be patient. My point about art and truth is this, April. Some things look real, but are not. And other things may appear to be of no consequence at all, but are in fact invaluable. Like Warren's painting here, and your dreams. There is both truth and illusion in dreams, and in the images they create. The problem is in sorting the one from the other.
You're telling me my dreams are true?
I'm telling you there are things afoot, and that you need help in sorting the truth from the illusions. My help.
Well, that figures.
Good. I was hoping you'd understand.
No, actually, I didn't understand a single word. You talk about art and truth and dreams and illusions, and I still don't understand what it all has to do with me. There are things happening, yes, and I came here because I thought maybe you're crazy enough to believe me, to help me. I don't know, sort through the debris and come up with the plausible explanation. But no, you tell me my dreams might be true, that I need your help, and that there are things afoot. I mean, who says afoot? I've never heard anybody use the word before. There are things afoot.
Está bien. I understand your reluctance to believe me, señorita. But I cannot convince you here, now. Meet me tomorrow.
What?
Meet me tomorrow, and I will tell you everything.
Not again. No way.
But you will. Because you are compelled to do so by your own curiosity. Because you are drawn to mystery, and because despite your skepticism, you believe I have the answer to all your questions, yes?
No. No, I don't care. I just want to have a normal life. No nightmares, no visions, no strangers telling me that things are afoot. Comprende, amigo?
Ay, Dios mío. Is that the time? I've got to run, señorita Reagan. I'll see you tomorrow, then.
I said...
Goodbye.
Oh, Cortez. Okay, let's see. Can I look at the painting again? Yes. Well, that's it. We can just look at it. So, this was drawing Cortez's attention. Well, guess enough art for today. So, back to Venice. Some scene going on over here, but yeah, nothing. A lot of extras in this adventure game, I must say. Now, we're supposed to work for Stanley later tonight at the cafe, but before we do that, I want to check out some stuff outside April's window. Because I remember that we had to do some stuff there sooner or later. If I remember correctly, it was in getting that key down on the subway tracks.
It's a seagull. The poor guy looks quite hungry.
So, what do you give a bird? Bread. I think. Let's see.
bank?
Hmm. Okay, the ducky's free.
I don't know what that chain's for, but it's connected to some kind of mechanism at the bottom of the canal.
Ah, okay, that unstuck it. And we end up with... clothesline. From a filthy canal.
It's a plastic-coated clothesline. I don't know what that chain's for, but it's connected to some kind of mechanism at the bottom of the canal.
Okay, we can't mess with that anymore. Oh, spikes.
Spiky.
Indeed. Okay, I guess that's it. Let's head back out.
Bon voyage, ducky!
Bye! Okay, now let's go back to the cafe. Wait a minute. This is new? Oh, it's a ducky.
It's a rubber ducky. It looks disturbingly familiar. But how the heck did it get all the way over here?
Through a maze of canals, I'm assuming.
Last I remember, the seagull had pecked a hole in the duck. Weird.
The hands of fate have band-aided the hole, apparently. Okay, so we can blow it up, but it'll probably deflate with that hole in it. Let's see, I remember that the glove had a hole in it.
It's a rubber glove, but it's pretty useless with that big hole in it.
Exactly. So let's use these two. Yay!
Rubber glove. Patched up, and good as new.
Okay, can we combine anything else here? No. So I think I'll end this video here, and we'll head into the cafe in the next video.